Namaste from Team India Ghoomo, it's Sarita and Kamal, and we welcome you to Hampi Tourism Part 3 video. In this video, we will cover the major tourist attractions that come under Group 2 of Sacred Center. We will cover Sasivekalu Ganpati, Kadilekalu Ganpati, Hemakut Hill, Virupaksh Temple, Hampi Bazaar and Monolithic Nandi. We recommend you to watch part 1 video before watching this one so that it's easier to understand this part. Before we get started, I have a little request. If you are new to this channel and haven't subscribed it yet, then please subscribe India Ghoomo to get notified of our future travel video uploads. Thanks for subscribing. Now let's begin. At a walkable distance from the main Hampi bus stand, situated at the foothills of Hemkut Hills, is a giant monolithic statue of Lord Ganesh called the Sasivekalu Ganesha. The statue of Sasivekalu Ganesha was built in 16th century by a mustard seeds merchant in memory of King Narasimha. Sasivekalu in Kannada means mustard, hence the name of the statue. This 8 feet tall statue of Lord Ganesh is seated in a half lotus posture on an open mantap with square pillars all around. Sasivekalu Ganesh statue has 4 hands. The upper hand has a goad and the broken tusk is held in the lower right hand. The upper left hand has a noose and the lower left hand is broken and has a sweet. You can see a beautifully carved snake around the Lord's pot belly. It is believed that Lord Ganesh once ate a lot of food, and to save himself from a belly explosion, he found a snake and quickly tied it around his cute belly. This temple was open for worship to the common citizens. Another huge Ganesh temple a bit north of Sasivekalu Ganesha called the Kadilekalu Ganesha was exclusive to the royal family. This 15 feet tall statue of Lord Ganesh was carved out of a huge boulder. The belly of this statue resembles a Bengal gram in local language called Kadilekalu, hence the name. There is an open porch with slender long pillars right in front of the Kadilekalu Ganesha temple. The Sasivekalu Ganesh and Kadilekalu Ganesh are located in the southern foothill of the Hemakut Hill. While it is not a tall hill, the Hemakut Hill is one of the main attractions in Hampi, offering spectacular sunset views. The hill is just a 15 minutes climb from the foothills of the Kadilekalu Ganesha. The top of the hill is a flat expanse of rocky sheet. A large number of temples, archways and pavilions, referred to as Hemakut group of temples, are built on the hill. Most of the Hemakut group of temples are dedicated to Lord Shiv and are among the oldest cluster of temples in Hampi belonging to the era before the Vijayanagara Empire. The architecture of these temples are different from Vijayanagara style architecture. These are compact triple-chambered structures with pyramid-like roofs made from granite. There are over 35 temples on the Hemakut Hill. The Mughal invasion has destroyed quite a number of temples, while some are in comparatively better condition. The Virupaksh Temple can be seen from the north side of the hill, offering a bird's-eye view of the temple complex. From here, we climb down the hill and proceed towards the Virupaksh Temple. Dedicated to Lord Shiv, Virupaksh Temple is believed to be functioning ever since its construction in the 7th century AD, making it one of the oldest functioning temples not just in Hampi but in India as well. The first thing that you will notice about this temple is 160 feet tall Gopuram or the entrance, making it the second highest in India. The first being that in the Meenakshi temple in Madurai. The huge Gopuram leads you to the first courtyard of the temple complex with a lot of open space. The courtyard houses a pillared hall called 100 Column Hall at the far left corner and a Kalyana Mantap at the far right corner. It also has administrative offices, ticket counter and a police outpost. Further forward, you will enter another Gopuram that leads to the second courtyard. Just before you make an entry through the second Gopuram, towards the left is a shoe safekeeping and a ticket counter. As you enter the inner complex, you will see the temple at the other end with long pillared corridors on the either sides of the huge empty space. In the middle of the empty space, you will see a sanctum with four Nandi statues in it, facing the entrance of the main Shiv temple. Photography is not allowed beyond this point. When you come out from the Virupaksha temple's main Gopuram, towards the left side of the lane is Hampi Bazaar, also called as Virupaksha Bazaar. There are numerous shops lined on both sides of the lanes, selling colorful artifacts, gypsy clothes, Lambani handicrafts and musical instruments that you can purchase. A huge monolithic Nandi, the Mount of Lord Shiv facing the Virupaksha temple, is located on the opposite end of the street in front of the Virupaksha temple. The Nandi statue is housed in a double-storied pavilion built on an elevated platform. A number of huge boulders behind the statue add an interesting backdrop. Towards the left side of the pavilion, a number of steps takes you to the Achyutaraya's temple, which is on the other side of the hill. We will cover Achyutaraya's temple in part 4 video. So that was all about the Hampi attractions that come under group 2 of the Sacred Center. I hope you found this video useful. Give this video a big thumbs up, leave us a comment down below and subscribe our channel India Ghoomo for more travel videos. Thanks for watching.